Good afternoon, friends. Now this video is explaining the construction of a network diagram for the given activities in module number 4 of the subject operation research. So here let us learn how to construct a network diagram for the given activities. So here we have the activities from A to I, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H and I. So here predecessor means the activity which comes before. So here A and B are the activities having no predecessor. So to these activities A and B, we don't have any activities before. That means A and B are the two beginners. So that is the activities with which the project has begun. So A and B are starting simultaneously. For these two activities, A and B, we don't have any predecessor. Then activity C is having the two predecessors here, A and B. So since A and B are the two activities here, we are taking the help of this dummy activity. So dummy activity will be represented by a dotted line with the arrow here. So that will not consume any time. So we can start the activity C once both A and B are over. So here for C, A is the predecessor as well as, so ignoring this dummy activity, so B is also the predecessor for the activity C. Similarly, for activity F, A and B are the predecessors. So with this node, or we call this circle as the node or event. So this is the node considered as ending event for the activity A as well as the activity B. So here, so B is shown here with followed by a dummy activity, so that we can say that so this is the ending event for both these activities A and B, whereas the same circle or the node is the beginning for these two activities C and F. So we can start these activities C and F only when A and B gets completed. So these are the situations in the network diagram. So here A must finish before either B or C can start. That is, I can start the activities B and C only when the activity A gets completed. So this is how we need to take the situation. Here both A and B must finish before C can start. So only when A and B gets completed, then only the activity C can be started. So here both A and C must finish before either B or D can start. So okay, so if you want to start the activity D, so it has to be A must be over, right? To start the next activity C, so these A and B must be over. So then A must finish before B. Okay, so that is before starting the activity B, A should be completed. And C must be finished before D can start. So before starting D, so C should be finished. So here it is said that A must be finished before B can start. Both A and C must be finished. Both A and C must be finished before D can start. So here we are taking the help of dummy activity to make sure that so D can be started only when both these A and C are finished. So coming to the given problem having these situations, so we are completing the network diagram like this. So A and B are the two activities which can be started in parallel without having any predecessor. Then for C and F, A and B are the two predecessors. So for C and F, A and B are the two predecessors. Then for D, B is the predecessor. And for E also, B is the predecessor. So after B, we can start E and D. After B, we can start E and D. So for E and D, B is the predecessor. So then for G and H, D and F are the predecessors. For G and H, we have two predecessors, D and F. So once D and F are over, from this event, we are starting the two activities, G and H. So then for the last activity I, G and C are the predecessors. So the next activity, so that is I. So for I, so it is G and H are the predecessors here. So here, so this is the diagram before completing the final diagram here. So here, so we should make sure that no circle should be isolated from the other circles. So if I use one more circle here to write I, so that these two circles remain isolated, so that we cannot do. So we are avoiding this circle. So directly I am joining E from this circle to this circle, and from here this circle I am drawing the activity I here. I. So that this is the last node. So only the beginning and the last node. So we will not have any further circles or the circles before this. The beginning node will not have any circle before this, and the last circle, that is the last event, will not have any further circle beyond this. So in between I cannot leave any of these circles without connecting to other circles. So these circles must be connected to one or the other circle. So the dummy activity can be used only when the situation demands. Unnecessarily we are not creating the dummy activities in the network diagram. So this is the final network diagram for the given data. Thank you, friends.